Are you in the middle of walking through a valley? Psalm 23:4 tells us, "Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me." It's inevitable, but we're all going to walk through a valley. Whether that valley is grief, brokenness, fear, conflict, whatever that valley is, whatever trouble it is, we're all going to have to go through a valley at one time or another. But I love how God gives us reassurance before he tells us that we will walk through the valley. He starts off the book of Psalm 23 with this: "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake." In those scriptures, God is promising us that he's our shepherd and that we're not going to lack for anything. When he tells us that he's going to lead us by the still waters, that tells me that's his peace that he is going to give us. He can give us peace through any valley that we walk through any valley that we go through. And going back to verse 4, did you notice those two words? "Yea, though I walk through the valley." God does not want us to stay in the valley. He won't let us stay in the valley. He wants us to walk through it. And he's going to be there every step of the way. Another scripture that has gotten me many of the valleys that I have walked through is Romans 8:28. "And we know that all things work together for good, to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose." What an amazing promise that is. Whatever valley it is that you're walking through, God promises that he's going to work it together for good. Life is hard, but God is good. We know that every valley we walk through, God is going to be with us. And I like how 2 Corinthians 4:17 tells us this: "For this light momentary affliction is preparing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison." Nothing's going to compare to when we get to heaven and God wipes away all our tears for every valley we have ever walked through. What is your valley that you're walking through? Let me encourage you to go back and read Psalm 23. He is your shepherd. He will be there to lead you and guide you. And at the end of that chapter, what does it tell us? "Surely, mercy and goodness will follow me all the days of my life." Let him be your shepherd as he walks with you through your valley so that you can grow in the Lord and influence the world all around you. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, may the Lord bless you and keep you. Goodbye.